Well, good afternoon, everybody. Michael Soothing here. I thought today what I would do is kind of review some of the money we have floating around here that's sort of strange, different money. I have now Joanne, my new Filipina spouse, and the reason I say Filipina is because some of the money is left over from the Philippines. And then we also have her daughter visiting, and she brought some New Zealand money because she was staying there for quite some time with her aunt, which would be Joanne's sister, Ataging. And then we have some money from Denmark, which is where they were both living for a good long many years. I wonder if... will I have to whisper this whole video? I don't know. Maybe we'll do a little bit of each, but I seem to be losing my voice. I may have to whisper. But that's okay, because in ASMR, you can whisper, or you can be soft spoken, either one. Let's start with the New Zealand money. This is interesting to me. They have a lot of features on this money that are not the same as our money. They have a clear thing you can see through there, sort of. See? I can see you. Can you see me through here? I think so. It's one of their security features. They have a logo here that's holographic or something with some kind of bird on it. This is some other kind of bird. They've got a lot of different kinds of birds in New Zealand. And it seems to me they should have put the kiwi on here. You know, that's kind of their national bird. I printed out a picture of one. A kiwi. Not a very good picture. But this is New Zealand's flightless bird. It pecks around. They're kind of cute in sort of a hedgehogish type of way. Don't you think? And people from New Zealand are often referred to as Kiwis because of that country's interesting bird. It only lives there, the Kiwi. Their notes, I don't know who that lady is on the front. Let's see if it says Kate Shepherd. Whoever that is. Maybe if you're a Kiwi and you're watching this, you can tell me who Kate Shepherd is. Now their money is worth about 2 to 1 to the dollar. Here's an older note with different security feature. See, that has a little round clear thing on it. Whereas the newer note with the duck has a much larger window on it. Anyway, so a $10 note, and they call them dollars, I see here, which is interesting. It says $10 if you look closely up there. $10 is worth about $5 US. So it's about a 2-to-1 ratio. This one is a $20 note, and it has two little windows on it. And this looks like a queen or a princess of some kind on the front. See? And it's got a clear window here, and one over here. And they both have some kind of holographic feature in them. It looks like some kind of a hawk or something on the back. If that's the name of it, it's called a Carraria. Carraria? I'm probably pronouncing it all wrong. But something like that. I'm going to move this so that I can see you better. And so you can see me better. So we have a 20 and a 10. What else do we have here? Here's a 5. I will show you. I have a couple of kinds of 5s. Here's a 5 with some kind of a penguin on the back and a small security window, right? Security feature window. And then here's a newer one, I think. It looks newer, and it's got a larger holographic window on the back of this one. They shine different ways when you turn it in the light different ways. I don't know if you can see that or not. Who's the guy on the front here? Reserve Bank of New Zealand, Te Putua Matua. That must be the indigenous way of saying it. Oh yeah, see this bird? When you move that back and forth, you get a shiny effect. And this guy looks like a rugged sort of guy. He is, oh, down at the bottom. It's not the Marlboro man or a guy advertising Chevy trucks. This guy is Sir Edmund Hillary. He has a rather interesting story, I believe. That guy, I believe, was the first guy to climb Mount Everest, which is the tallest mountain in the world. And I think he climbed it not too long before about the year I was born. He was an adventurer. Mount Everest is very difficult to climb because it has the tallest mountain on Earth. It's about 29,000 feet high, as I recall. And if you get up to that altitude, not only is it very, very cold, but the air pressure is much lower. So you can get fluid on your brain and embolisms and things. And also, there's only about 1/3 as much oxygen up there. So you have to take oxygen tanks with you, really, if you want to climb that high. Many have died in the attempt, and they're still frozen up on the mountain up there. So this was quite a feat to be the first guy. You may have heard that there are higher mountains than Everest in the past, like K2, but it isn't true. After they got done remeasuring everything properly with satellite technology, Everest remained king at 29,000 and something feet. So anyway, that's just an aside. This guy even came into politics because Hillary Clinton falsely claimed that her parents named her after this guy because they were so impressed with his mountain climbing feat, until many people pointed out to her, she did this for a decade or two, until many people pointed out that he climbed that mountain several years after she was named and born. So, just one of about, well, we don't want to get into politics, do we? But anyway, you can look it up on Snopes.com if you don't believe me. Next up, we have Filipino money. We have, who's on the front of this one? Corazon Aquino. And I think her husband was in the Senate and she was like the president or prime minister. And so you see there, the two of them on this banknote. This is a 500 peso note. And in the Philippines, there is a ratio of 10 to 1, I mean 50 to 1, I should say, of dollars to pesos. So this would be the equivalent of a $10 bill in the United States, this 500 peso note. And so, you know, if you were a millionaire in the Philippines, you would only have about $20,000. So I say only, not as if everyone has that much laying around, you know. But anyway, it's kind of interesting. I think this says Republica Ng Nang. Let's see, Republica Ng Pilipinas is how you're supposed to say that. And hopefully I won't get in trouble with YouTube censorship for saying the country the way they pronounce it there. But the way things are going, as I mentioned in my censorship video, and a lot of you will say in comments, well, I see people posting all kinds of things and they're not being censored. But you see, it's a different kind of censorship. They won't let you be monetized. So you can still use profanity and all that kind of thing, or say something that is controversial or political or sarcastic or satire or any one of millions of other things, but you just will get censored from advertisers. Unless you only talk about, you know, Kraft marshmallows or something, even then you'll probably get censored for some reason. But here we are diverging. What else do we have? We have another guy. I don't know if I'm Limon Pung Piso. This is a 50 note, so that's worth a dollar in U.S. money. Seems like a little bit of a ripoff, but they used to have a ratio of 1 to 1 long ago, but I guess the money got devalued somewhere along the way. Republica ng Pilipinas. Here is a 100 peso note, and it's got an interesting volcano on the back. See? It's a big one. Do you remember when Mount Pinatubo erupted in the Philippines? It changed global climate for about a year because so much ash and things went into the upper atmosphere. Lowered the temperature slightly all over the globe. And here is some 20 peso notes. Yeah, so that's worth about 33 cents, okay? Now, let's see, what else do we have? I think there's some Denmark money here someplace. But, yes, right here. In Denmark, in order to save a little bit on printing costs, they have what's called crowns, like in a lot of the Scandinavian countries. But instead of printing notes, they have coins for the lower value ones. So a 20 crown, let's see, how much is this one? Yeah, this one is a 20 crown. 20 krona. I think they say krona or something like that. 20 crown value coin. Their money is running about 7-to-1 ratio. So 20 crowns is about $3 US, roughly. What do they got on the front here of this 20 crown coin? It's 20 krona. Landet Kirke. And Landet Kirke means the national church or the country's church. See it there? Once upon a time, the church and the government were not fully distinct from each other. So there was kind of a nationalized church that was subsidized by the government, which is not such a good idea for the government or for the church, because they should be independent of each other, which is what we try to do in the States, but the church in Europe has mostly died. Now they're all like museums, but they're empty because Europe is primarily secularized. But I think that's interesting. They put that on the 20 kroner. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong. I should get Joanne in here to be my consultant, since she's fluent in Danish and Swedish, and also in Tagalog or Filipino language, as well as English. I would like to have that gift to be able to learn other languages as she does, but I'm not so good at it. I don't think I can learn them easily at this station in life because my memory's not good enough to learn a few tens of thousands of new words. But anyway, I have some of those kroner. Then we have a couple of Danish coins that have a hole in them. And not sure why it has the hole in it. Maybe that's so that you can know what it is if you're vision impaired or something like that, I'll bet. That's a guess on my part. How much money is this worth? Let's see. I see the date on it, on the front, 2006. Can you see it? It's reflective, this coin. Is it on the other side? Denmark. I wonder if they pronounce it Denmark. We say Denmark and we spell it different. There it is. Oh, it's a 5 kroner coin. 5 krona. And so this would be the equivalent of about 80 cents or so, roughly. Almost a dollar as far as U.S. money, the U.S. dollar. But look, there's little hearts. They're happy about their money. Check it out. Maybe this is a Valentine coin. See the little heart at the top and at the bottom? What else can we notice here? Oh, we can notice that somebody's math isn't very good in Denmark because it's a 5 crown coin. But if you look at the back, I only see 3 crowns. Do you see 3 crowns? So do I. So somebody's math is messed up. Okay. I'm being facetious, of course. This is probably an insignia that they use in Scandinavia, and they just wanted this design or whatever. Anyway, if your money had holes in it like this, you could make a necklace or something out of it, right? What else? Here is... oh. I have a British coin. How I got that, I don't know. but it's all beat up and messed up. It's Queen somebody or other. Elizabeth, I think. And it's a 1 pound coin. But it doesn't weigh a pound, you know. So, it only weighs a fraction of an ounce. And Maria traveled here via Iceland. So she picked up along the way a 5-crowned Icelandic coin that looks like a couple of dolphins or something. Either that or there's perhaps killer whales, orcas, but I think there's some type of dolphin that must hang around Iceland, right? What do they have on the back? It says they're an island. Fimkroner Island, 2008. And there's some logo, interesting stuff on the back there, see? I don't know why, but I'm fascinated by numismatics of every kind. That means coin stuff, coin collecting. And what else do we have here? Oh, I was going to show you some weird U.S. money while I'm at it. It's not really weird. It's just a little older and different. And as long as we were on the topic, I thought I would show you. I have a bunch of what they call silver certificates. And it looks at first glance quite a bit like your normal money, right? That you have in your wallet. If you're so fortunate as to have any in your wallet. But if you look more closely, you'll see that what you have in your wallet says at the top, Federal Reserve Note. Wait, let's get one out of the wallet and see. We'll get something out of the wallet, and you can see, who's this guy? Hamilton? Yeah. Anyway, you can see at the top it says, Federal Reserve Note, up at the top there. Yeah. Federal Reserve. We the people. Okay. Let's just stick with that for a moment. I was tempted to go off track, but I resisted the temptation. Okay. But if you look at this old money I have, this older money, it says at the top, silver certificate. See that? Silver certificate. And that means once upon a time, this was actually backed by silver. You could redeem this dollar for a dollar's worth of silver. Yeah, and they changed that law, I believe, around 19, late 1960s or something. Oh, I should know, because I'm into this whole numismatics, and this has a different name when you're into stamps and paper money. But anyway, you can see the design was a little different too. So I have some of these. I think I had a $5 one too. Let me see if I can find it. Oh yeah, here it is. With Lincoln. It says at the top, silver certificate. And these older ones are worth more than their face value, but they're not worth a lot more because, of course, there are many millions of them still in existence. They're worth about 2.5-3 times their face value, something like that. Here is an interesting but very beat up and water damaged note, U.S. note, that is not a silver certificate. It is an even older type called a gold certificate, a 20. And if you look closely, where does it say? Oh, by the seal here, it says gold certificate. It's got a tear, so I have to hold it very carefully. But do you see where it says gold certificate? And this note was redeemable in actual gold once upon a time from Fort Knox. So once upon a time, our paper money had actual intrinsic value. Of course, it still does, but in a different way, which I don't want to diverge and try to explain at this moment, because that would take too long. A lot of people say our money is just paper, fiat currency, and it has no actual value. It's just pretend, and it will all collapse someday. But that's actually because it's no longer backed by gold and silver. But that's actually a fallacy, because our US dollar is actually backed by something. It's backed by what they call the full faith and credit of the country or the government, which means that it's backed by the economic activity, the natural resources, the system of government, the defense, and on and on in that vein, the technology of the country. It's just used as a medium of exchange, but the actual value of it has to do with the country's economic production. So that's a concept I would have to develop a lot more fully in its separate video to convey the message properly. That doesn't mean I don't think gold and silver are good investments. I think they can be a good addition to a portfolio, and I believe they will have intrinsic value even if the dollar is debased and devalued over time by making too many paper dollars. You can certainly devalue it if you're the government by printing too much of it, by creating too much pretend money using a credit-based system where every dollar printed results in $9 loaned by the banking system. So you created $10 out of thin air. Poof. But it is still tied to something. So if someone tells you it's valueless, they're not correct. Unless you think, for example, that the largest economy on earth and the best military on earth, and so far pretty much the most successful political system on earth, even with its flaws, of course, and some of the best natural resources, being the center of the tech world and all those things, if you think all of those things have zero value, then of course the dollar would have zero value also, all right, other than whatever somebody just made up. But we would have to explore that concept by talking about history and bonds and treasury bonds and the Federal Reserve and a whole lot of other things that would definitely put you to sleep even more effectively than what we're doing here. So for now, I think we'll stop here, and I hope this was relaxing to you, as it was for me. I enjoy talking about, you know, all kinds of things that have to do with other places in the world and that kind of thing. I would like to visit New Zealand sometime so that I can spend a Sir Edmund Hillary $5 New Zealand bill and see a Kiwi, of course. When Maria was there, you should go to her channel. She did some vlogs. Her channel's name, Art and Beauty Freak, and Ariaville. If I can remember, I'll write it on the bottom of the screen, okay? As well as my wife's ASMR McBong channel, which is, of course, Scorpio NYT. So, please give this a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I will, of course, make many more types in the future. In addition, as time allows, I had refugees here for some time from the Santa Rosa fire. My dad and my mom, kind of stepmom, but I call her my mom. So, I got busy for a while. Anyway, take care, everyone. Don't ASMR and drive, okay? All right, bye-bye.